And welcome to a new video of my Unity MMO tutorial series. And in this series, we will continue with our character selection. Okay, in this case, we need to change some stuff because what I did in the last video isn't really good. So we can delete this one, and we have to go to our YukiNet, and in our YukiNet at first we go to our package parser because we have to fix some stuff I found out with debugging, and this is because we have the register variables and we add some stuff here, so we had to distinct and we added the where clause from link, and this is that this is because we don't want to register some stuff twice. That's why I added this stuff here, and our logger information with the count package types we can do here because we don't want to give that out twice, because we can load the package here the resolve package, and we load the resolve package here so that we don't have any problems. And I guess that's all. And now we have no problems with loading twice. And for our character selection, we go to our character selection character creation package, and we go to the selection response field, and we can delete this because we don't need it. We create a new IE enumerable, and for this we added a new field, and we call it char data, and we call this one characters, and we need a getter and a setter, and then we declare a list out of it, and in the constructor. And now at first we can delete this, and we can delete this one, and at the end we need to add our public class char data, and in this one we put the public string char name get set, and we have the public int char id get set, and we also add the public string uma data get set, and now we have our char data field that we create a list of it in here. And now we go to our serialize to stream, and this is we add a new writer, so writer.write, and now we say byte, and we add the characters.count. And I have to add the namespace using system.link. And Yeah, this is now we count the characters who is sent, and we declare it as byte because we don't want to send more than 255 characters for one player. And now we create a for each where we write our data, and now it's very easy. It's writer.write, and we have to take the characters, sorry. And the first one will be the star ID. The second one, I will copy it two times because we need the char name. And we also need the UMA data. And now we write everything, every character we have in the database to the stream. And now we go to the deserialize method, and we now add the count, and we read the byte, not bytes, we need a byte, and it's not cout, it's count, and now we add a new list. From char data. And now we say for int I is equal to null. And if is I is smaller than count, then we will add 1 to the plus, and then we say char list dot add new char data, and then we say char id is equal to reader dot read int 33. And char name is equal to reader.read a string. And we have the UMA data is equal to reader.read string. Okay. And I guess that's all for our stream. So now we send and get the data. And now we can build it. And we have to go to our models, to our, not the models, we have to go to our, yeah, we have to go to our models in the server, and we have to go to the character model. And we have to add some stuff down below. And this will be a public static explicit char data character model model. And now we have to add the namespace. And we have to say return new char data. And we have the char ID. Okay, I have to add this one, okay. And this will be the char ID model.id and char name equals to model.char name and UMA data equal to model.UMA data. This is because we need to say that the character model can be the char data. And I forgot something, I need to add the operator. I need the operator name, and now we can... I don't know why I have to use this one yet. And we will do the same for the returning, so we can say that the static explicit operator can be character model and char data model, and we do the same ID. Now it's ID equal to model.charID and char name equal to model.char name, and we have to add the UMA data is equal to model.UMA data. And okay, I know the error yet, and it's because this, and now I can add and I forgot this one here. Sorry. Return new character model. And now it's right. Sorry for this. And now we have no errors in here yet, I guess. And now we can go to the character selection, and the only thing we have to do is characters equals to character. And as you can see, we have an error. This is because we cannot do this as this one. We have to add some I only want the X, and now we have to convert it to char data. And we need to add the using system.link, and we have to add the namespace for our Yuki system package implementation. And I don't know why I have to add the static one, but we can check. Oh, it's everything is okay. Ah, okay, I put it on in a wrong way, so in the character you have to put it here, not in the package here. We need to add it only in the normal namespace, and then we can go here and delete the static as well. Course we don't need it. And yeah, that was everything for now, and let's do the rest in the next video. And if you like what I've done, then you can subscribe me on Patreon, or you can leave a like or write something down in the comments. And if you have any problems, you can write it down in the comments as well, or join my Discord server. Thank you for watching.